September 1984, 6 months into the miners' strike, 3 months after the bloody Battle of Orgreaves, and the public's interest was drifting elsewhere to a newborn baby called Harry.
It's good news, which I'm sure most of you have heard already, that our Princess of Wales has had a son.
By daybreak, several hundred pickets were still refusing to disperse. This 4 hours after the miner had got into the colliery.
Now, different and more shocking images were taking over the news. Not fights on picket lines, but scenes of starvation, a world away in Africa.
Thousands of wasted people are coming here for help. Many find only death.
The images we saw were just hideous, and I think it would affect anyone, any person with any kind of sensitivities at all. But I think that the main tool for getting me involved was Bob. You can't really say no to him, you know, he's an animal. And when we got together, the only thing we could do was write a song and make a record and get as many people come together on it as possible. So I think Christmas, jingle bells, da 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 da. Bob played me this thing. And it won't be snow in Ethiopia, it is Christmas. And I kind of, yeah, okay, play it again. And he played it and it was completely different. And my big contribution was changing "and there won't be snow in Ethiopia this Christmas" to "Africa," which scans, because Bob's got no sense of time and it's dreadful.
And there won't be snow in Africa this Christmas time.
And just at the very end of the song, Bob said, "We need an anthem. We need it to finish on this big rousing thing." And one of us, the two of us, or either of us, I don't know, I can't remember, came up with this "Feed the World." And we started singing that. And of course, that made the song.
Feed the world.
We had only 24 hours to do it all, mixed the record, because we had to have it in the pressing plants by 8 o'clock next morning in order to get it out in time for Christmas.
Britain's best-selling record this week, and also the fastest-selling record ever. It's Band Aid and Do They Know It's Christmas. Till next week. Good night.
Band-Aid is quite symbolic in that it was a new sort of politics, I think. The miners' strike was the last sort of dying gasp of old-fashioned, organised union sort of activism. And in the same year, we had this new sort of politics, a celebrity appearing on the television saying, "Send in your money for these children in Africa," a more sort of global sort of appeal.
But don't forget, so there are millions dying, and yes, that's the terrible thing.
Yes, indeed.
That was the sort of way that politics, I think, was heading, celebrity-based rather than class-based.